Hi everybody, my name is Terry Morrow. I'm the choir director and one of the music teachers at Back of the Arts College Prep High School. Thanks for checking out our channel and our video. The series that we're gonna debut right now is a alumni series. The students that you're gonna see in these videos are alumni from our Taste of Broadway shows. We call it Taste of Broadway because we're not doing full-blown shows start to finish. We kind of sprinkle in other influences, other artists, and other songs with one sort of theme overall. So the first year we did selections from Hamilton. Second year was selections from Natasha Pierre and the Great Comet of 1812. The third Taste of Broadway was American Idiot, which was the Green Day musical. And this year, before COVID-19 took over everything, we had planned to do selections from Dear Evan Hansen and other artists as well. I'm gonna let Alma and Tyrese take over video one as they explain to you what happened with the Taste of Broadway. I do remember for Hamilton the first year, we didn't have our headset mics yet. So everything we did was running through like Shure SM57 microphones that had like 40-foot cables attached to them. Everyone was so new to it, and that made it really special and really fun. And it also was a tangled mess of microphone cables. Lots of cables. It was kind of a mess. The Taste of Broadway is really dear to my heart because to me it says so much about students coming together with a goal. We encountered so many bumps in the road, but I think we all kind of attacked them together and we were better for it at the end. We're gonna walk down memory lane right now and we're gonna show you guys and girls alumni who are graduated from school, but who were kind enough to submit videos and to kind of relive some of these Taste of Broadway moments that we had together. This is the first clip of quite a few that we're gonna be uploading over the next few weeks. And I hope you enjoy.
Hi, I'm Alma Sigal from class of 2018, and I played the role of Alexander Hamilton in Back of the Arts' first ever Taste of Broadway, and the following year I played Maria in Natasha Pierre and the Great Comet of 1812, where I sang Welcome to Moscow and In My House, which was one of my favorite things to perform that year. The Taste of Broadway shows for me really helped me come out of my shell, and they really helped me come out of my comfort zone a little bit, and really gave me a lot of confidence to be who I am today, and they were really fun. And really great memories and such a great experience to be a part of. When I was cast as Hamilton, it felt like such a big shock, but I knew that I could do it because like it didn't matter whether or not I was a boy or a guy to play a male role. It mattered how much effort I was putting into it, and it felt really great to know that the choir class and, you know, Mr. Morrow had that much confidence in me to pull it off. And I feel like everybody did such a great job that year and the following year too, and it was such a great experience to share with everybody, and it was really fun. This next song is Cabinet Battle 1 from the first show that we did, and thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, you could have been anywhere in the world tonight, but you're here with us in New York City. Are you ready for a cabinet meeting? The issue on the table: Secretary Jefferson's plan to assume state debt and establish a national bank. Secretary Jefferson, you have the floor, sir.
Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. We fought for these ideals, we shouldn't settle for less. These are wise words, enterprising men quote them. Don't act surprised, you guys, cause I wrote them. Ow, but Hamilton forgets. His plan would have the government assume state debts. Now place your bets as to who that benefits. The very seat of government where Hamilton sits. Ooh, if the shoe fits, wear it. If New York's in debt, why should Virginia bear it? Our debts are paid, I'm afraid. Don't tax the South, cause we got it made in the shade. In Virginia, we plant seeds in the ground. We create, you just wanna move our money around. This financial plan is an outrageous demand, and it's too many damn pages for any man to understand. Stand with me in the land of the free, and pray to God we never see Hamilton's candidacy. Look, when Britain taxed our tea, we got frisky. Imagine what gon' happen when you try to tax our whiskey.
Thank you, Secretary Jefferson. Secretary Hamilton, your response.
Thomas, that was a real nice declaration. Welcome to the present, we're running a real nation. Would you like to join us? Or stay mellow doing whatever the hell it is you do in Monticello? If we assume the debts the union gets, a new life credit, a financial diuretic. How do you not get it? If we're aggressive and competitive, the union gets a boost, you'd rather give it a sedative? A civics lesson from a slaver. Hey neighbor, your debts are paid because you don't pay for labor. We plant seeds in the south, we create and keep ranting. We know who's really doing the planting. And another thing, Mr. Age of Enlightenment, don't lecture me about the war. You didn't fight in it. You think I'm frightened of you, man? We almost died in the trench while you were off getting high with the French. Thomas Jefferson, always hesitant with the president. Reticent, there isn't a plan he doesn't jettison. Madison, you mad as a hatter, son, take your medicine. Damn you, in worse shape than the national debt is. Sitting there useless as two. Hey, turn around, bend over, I'll show you where my shoe fits.
Excuse me, Madison, Jefferson, take a walk. Hamilton, take a walk. We will reconvene after a brief recess. Hamilton, a word.
You don't have the votes. You don't have the votes. Ah, ha, 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 ha. You're gonna need congressional approval and you don't have the votes. Such a blunder sometimes, it makes me wonder why I even bring the thunder.
You want to pull yourself together?
I'm sorry, these Virginians are birds of a feather.
Young man, I'm from Virginia, so watch your mouth.
So we let Congress get held hostage by the South?
You need the votes.
No, we need bold strokes. We need this plan.
No, you need to convince more folks.
James Madison won't talk to me. That's a non-starter.
Winning was easy, young man. Governing's harder.
They're being intransigent.
You have to find a compromise.
Well, they don't have a plan. They just hate mine.
Go convince them otherwise.
Do what happens if I don't get congressional approval.
I imagine they'll call for your removal.
Sir.
Figure it out, Alexander. That's an order from your commander.